What's up guys, welcome back to Warframe. I didn't even plan on making this video, but something fairly interesting, at least for me, happened. I was prompted upon logging into Warframe, as prompted with a choice. Teshin here asked me to pick a weapon, and I don't think that's a regular occurrence, since it says right there, 100 days. That's actually a milestone I've apparently achieved. 100 days of logging in into Warframe, I suppose. Right, so I had a selection of three different weapons. First of which was a pistol, a secondary weapon called a Zima. And it says, this intricate automatic pistol is able to fire its magazine, which then spins in the air for a short time, firing lasers at nearby enemies. That sounds pretty freaky. So already a pretty interesting choice in the shape of this pistol here. But if I was to move on, the second weapon in here, looking like some sort of a staff, it's probably a melee weapon, right? Zenistar. It says, scorch enemies with blistering blows, or set them ablaze with a flying fire disc. It's pretty funny. It actually leaves you to select the method you wish to do the killing with. Funny stuff. Truth be told, I already got my Xoris. I don't think I'll be replacing it anytime soon. It's extremely overpowered. I should probably make a video about that soon enough. But anyway, my third option. Third option is pretty much a primary weapon by the looks of it. It's called Zenith, and it says, deploy the radar disc to reveal hidden enemies and then strike with precision shots that punch through all obstacles in the way. Okay. Basically a rifle, right? Anyway, long story short, I've picked a Zima. I got no clue if that was a bad choice or not. Truth be told, I think things are rather balanced, so it doesn't quite matter which one you picked. I got no regrets, I went with a Zima. Hopefully, Teshin is gonna give me some, other free stuff in the future as well. We will see. Right, guys, so here we are in the game a few days later. I've already maxed it. This is what the gun looks like. Well, matching my costume, it looks really weird. Definitely does. Anyway, I'm just gonna equip it, and I guess I'm gonna show you what it plays like. It's got no mods, it's super stock as it can get. Let's get into a random mission and play with it. Alright, so here we are. I got my gun out. I haven't noticed, I don't think I've used it that much. It's likely I've used my Xoris while maxing this, so I haven't had enough time to play with it. What does it feel like? Okay, it feels like a pistol, nothing to oh! It's definitely an automatic one. Right. What about the magazine? Oh! Was gonna say, what about the description saying something about the magazine jumping? Oh, this one, I've seen these. I have seen these, so I guess they do damage, right? I can only assume that. So, can I fire these only when I'm reloading, or can I just fire them whenever I wish? Oh no, I can fire them whenever I wish. Rather convenient. It's a shame I haven't discovered this earlier, even though I don't think it deals that much damage, especially with no mods equipped. I'm gonna find some unfortunate enemies and play with them for a while. Oh, that looks like an unfortunate enemy to me. Let's see how much damage can it... Oh wow, he actually blew into pieces. Impressive, unless my Texan did it. Can I shoot multiple of these? Oh, I can, wow. But they take... Wow, they take 75. God, I'm out of ammo now. Because that's technically my magazine, my entire magazine. Okay, well, rip, I'm out of ammo. But I think that's pretty much what it does. You can either discharge your full magazine that resemble regular bullets, or just do that gimmick thingy to fire around a 360 area, I believe. Right, interesting. I don't think I'm gonna be using it anymore, though. Right. That said, yeah. Oh my god, Oris is so... Okay, I'm gonna check my inbox. Fine. Was gonna say that's pretty much it. Wow, I got a crap ton of affinity boosters. I got a event affinity booster and a regular affinity booster. Do they stack? Because if they do, the experience I can gain is pretty insane. It's a shame I can't play. I gotta go in my holidays. Not gonna be home for this. Oh well, rip that. Oh right, inbox. What? Oh, yeah, I've received lots of stuff from Lotus. That's for you. Oh, all right. Hey, gifts from Inushiba, who says, here you go, bud. Get some for yourself. Thank you so, so much. Happy holidays, you know. Unwrap. Oh my god, no way. Domestic zone bundle, are you freaking kidding me? Are these the little guys that play, that walk around your ship? I like to call them vacuum cleaners. Wait a second. Can I go to equipment, arbiter, decorate? One. Oh my freaking god. About placing my vacuum cleaners. This is insane. Can I dictate like a path for them to follow? Or would they just go randomly around my ship? This is insane. Thank you so, so much. This is the best. This is the best Christmas present. That is freaking insane. Let me place them down. I hope they. Maybe they don't travel. I don't know. They still look like vacuum cleaners to me, so it's a win. Right. Oh, I should also place my sigil. Stick to the freaking surface. Maybe like that's gonna trigger some people. Anyway, we seem to be done. Oh god, they do. What's up with these? Some of them seemed bugged, but maybe it's because of my placement. God, this is so awesome! And I can ride them, right? Wait, maybe not that guy. Can I ride you? Oh, no, only in missions? I think it's only in missions. Oh, don't go there! That's way too much for you to clean that room. That's a no-no. Anyway, guys, pretty exciting stuff. This is definitely gonna be it for today. I got quite impressed by the 100 login day reward. Had no clue such a thing was, existed. And I think I'm actually gonna end the video on a pretty sad and ashamed of myself note. By the time this video likely launches, or rather goes live, you've probably seen the Second War and the War Within. While everything went smoothly with the Second War quest, I screwed up big time for the War Within. I don't know what happened. I honestly, well, I got clues, I guess. Something hardware-wise malfunctioned, or I got no clue, freak if I know. But the recorder I'm using didn't catch any game audio whatsoever, and I was devastated, honestly, when I first realized upon editing the video, but I don't know, there's literally nothing I can do right now. At the time you're seeing both quests, I'm out of town, which, yeah, kinda sucks. But right, I can only wish you happy holidays, and thank you so, so much for watching, even so. I hope there's not gonna be too many insults, and too many unsubscribes. Anyway, guys, I'll see you on the next one.